was a dominating performance by Swiss ski racer Ramon Zenhäusern at the Granada 2015 Winter Universiade. Fighting his way through poor visibility and tricky snow conditions, Zenhäusern built a substantial 1.35 second advantage after the first run of the men's slalom there in the Sierra Nevada mountains of Spain. Skies clearing and with a nearly insurmountable lead, Zenhäusern charged brazenly in his second run, demonstrating power and precision en route to a Winter Universiade gold medal and a most memorable experience. Now a two-time Olympic medalist and seasoned World Cup competitor, the 28-year-old Zenhäusern has remained committed to his studies. He recently earned a bachelor's degree in economics. With pursuits of a master's degree and World Cup slalom title within his sight, all indicators show that Zenhäusern is bullish about his future. Hello and welcome to another edition of the FISU University Legends interview series. I'm Brian Pinelli. And we're honored to be joined by the Swiss alpine skier, currently at a training camp in Livigno, Italy, Ramon Zenhäusern. Hello, Ramon. How are you doing today?
Hi, everybody. I'm pretty fine.
Thanks for joining us, Ramon. I know the winter season is just in front of us. Obviously, a tricky time with the coronavirus, events being canceled, rescheduled, difficult to train. I guess, first off, Ramon, how are things going for you? How has training been? And what's your outlook for the upcoming Winter World Cup season?
No, the training was pretty good this season. We trained a lot in the Swiss Glacier in Saas-Fee and Zermatt. And now, 2 weeks ago, we went to the Scandinavia, to Sweden, for training camps for 2 weeks. And now this week in Livigno, and then next week in Pozza di Fossa, and then on the 21st, it will be the first race for me this season in Alta Badia, hopefully. And after, the day after, in Madonna di Campiglia. After, there were a lot of races.
Ramon, obviously you've had such a nice career already. We'll get to the Universiade gold medal from 2015, the gold and silver medal at the Pyeongchang Olympic Winter Games, and on the World Cup Tour. You've now been fourth the past two seasons in the World Cup slalom standings, near the top with your teammate Daniel Yule. I don't know if people know this, but it's been a long time since a Swiss men's alpine slalom skier has won a World Cup globe. You have to go all the way back to 1968, way before you were born. Just wondering, what will it take for either yourself or your teammate Daniel to finally get to the top of that slalom World Cup this season?
Yeah, it's crazy that the Swiss haven't had no slalom team the last few years. And now we have a pretty good team also with Daniel, and there are other guys skiing pretty fast. And I think it's because we have a good trainer staff. They did really good work. And yes, for us, we take race by race, and we don't think to the globe or things like that. But yes, I'm pretty happy with my career at the moment. I reach a lot of goals already, and I try my best for the future. But I think the most important thing is to stay healthy and to have fun. And after all these results, and also maybe a globe will come also into Switzerland.
All right. Good luck with the upcoming season, of course. Continue to do great things. When you go on your Instagram, Ramon, I like this. You say tall Swiss alpine ski racer. You are 2 meters two, or 6 feet 8 inches. Now, when I think of a slalom skier, I think of more of a compact skier like Marcel Hirscher, Alberto Tamba, Henrik Kristoffersen. You're obviously a lot taller, and you've made it work for you. Just curious, so you know, what has it taken to be successful as such a tall skier, and does it pose any challenges in the slalom?
Yeah, it's right. There were a lot of people who never thought that I will reach in slalom because, in the brains, the people think a slalom skier is small and not tall. And so I worked hard for it. I did special training exercises because with my height, I have to train different than smaller guys. I had trained a lot of balance stuff, the balance in front and behind. It's more really important for me, or also the upper body, that the upper body is stable. And yeah, it's a little bit different training exercises that I do. And I'm really proud that I could show the world that you can also ski slalom fast with 2 meters.
So better for you to be a skier than a basketball player or a volleyball player?
That I don't know. That I don't know. I have a girlfriend. She's playing beach volleyball. And when I go with her on tour sometimes on summer, I'm not the only one who is 2 meters high. So maybe I fit better in beach volleyball. But no, I'm pretty happy with skiing.
You're doing well. Hey, Ramon, let's go back to the Winter Universiade 2015 in Granada, Spain, in the beautiful Sierra Mountains. Now, you were 22 at the time, and unlike most of the other student athletes, you already had the experience having competed at the Sochi 2014 Olympic Winter Games. But nevertheless, so what was the experience there in Granada like for you as a young student athlete?
Yeah, it was so a nice experience because in the beginning, I was a little bit angry because I wasn't selected for the World Championships in Beaver Creek, even if I had some top 30 results, but it was not enough that year. And after there was the possibility to participate in this Winter Universiade in Granada, and it was so amazing experience. A new region there, the Alhambra. We lived in Granada. We were visiting Alhambra. And also this special atmosphere with the other athletes who study beside. I'm really happy that I have this experience. I like it a lot. And also I won this race, and it helped me also with the FIS points. I mark a 6. And with this 6, I can start it earlier after in the World Cup, or had security. All in all, really good stuff.
Let's talk about your racing there. I know you were 6th in the giant slalom. 2 days later, the final event, the slalom, as it usually is. The first run was under difficult conditions, quite foggy. You still built up a huge lead, more than a second, over a French skier. And then in the second run, the sun came out, and you really made it look easy, kind of a victory lap. I mean, you won this by over 3 seconds. So were you feeling any pressure, or was this just like, I'm going to, you know, enjoy the sunny day and win this easily?
Yeah, I didn't remember what I thought exactly at the start, but it was a difficult day because the slope was pretty rough. And with my long legs, I could play really well in this in this slope. And then when I was at the finish and I saw this victory with over 3 seconds advance, I was wondering, it was a crazy stuff. Yeah, and there were some good French skiers also there. I think Robin Buffet and this. So helped me a lot also for the self-confidence.
What about going into the first run? I mean, again, you know, you're a young guy, but you had competed in Sochi 1 year before. So I don't want to, you know, put words in your mouth and say this was easy, but you had more experience than probably a lot of the other competitors.
Yeah, maybe. I had more experience. But it was so good organized also, the whole event. You can compare it to the Olympic Games in Sochi. So good organization. Maybe not a lot of spectators, but otherwise the event was so good organized, and it helped me maybe already the Sochi Olympic Games after for winning in Granada.
Now this is fun. So you win the slalom, if I'm not mistaken, on Saturday, February the 14th. And that evening was the closing ceremony in Granada. So you win the race.
Yeah, exactly.
You have the victory ceremony, I assume a quick celebration. And then you had to get to the closing ceremony. How did that go? And You obviously were able to make this all work in a tight time frame.
Yeah, it was all good organized. There were private shuttles and this ceremony. And after it was also a nice evening in Granada, because Granada is a student city. And we went out for some hours, the disco, and we celebrated this victory. I think I will never lose this this nice experience that I did down there.
Now, often for slalom skiers, we said the slalom typically at a multi-sport event is on the last weekend. So, you know, you're, I assume, somewhat focused and need to train and prepare. But what about the whole Universiade experience? You know, when did you arrive there in Granada? Did you see some other events? And what was it like around the athletes' village for you?
I think I arrived maybe 2 or 3 days before the giant slalom. And then we trained. We trained 2 days up in Granada. Yeah, it's a nice ski resort too.
And they potentially might bid for the 2030, you know, Winter Olympics. So maybe it's an area that a lot of racers don't think about. But does it have a different atmosphere than, you know, the traditional Alps there in Switzerland and Austria?
Yeah, exactly. I remember in Granada, you can see to Africa, to the Sahara in Africa. You see over the sea in the upper part. That was also amazing.
Yeah, good stuff, Ramon. Now, also, looking back, you know, you're already a relatively top skier on the World Cup circuit. As we talked about, you competed in Sochi. At this point of your career, were you juggling studies as well? Were you still attending university? How did you kind of, you know, combine the two of those aspects?
Yeah, I finished my bachelor in economics last year. And for the moment, I'm focused on skiing. And but maybe I will join a master. If the Fern University in Switzerland have the masters, I probably will do it. But for the moment, it doesn't exist the master of in economic in the university in distance in Switzerland. But it helped me a lot to study also besides, because otherwise you think the whole day about skiing, and when you have some books with you, when you learn, you're completely in a different world. And also for the future, after my ski career, I have to work, I have to do something. And also, with the injuries, you never know. It can be so fast finished, and then I have something in the hand. So for me, it was always good to study, and it was normal for me to do studies.
Yeah. Obviously, it looks like you have many good years ahead of you with your World Cup ski career as a relatively young guy. Just kind of expanding on your previous answer, have you decided what you'd like to do after ski racing?
No, not yet. No, maybe working in the FISU. No, I don't know for the moment. Maybe something in sport, management, or in federation. I don't know yet. But I hope to ski 10 more years about. But for that, I have to keep my health.
Ramona, send us your CV, although more credit to you. I think it would be tough to juggle studies, a full-time job at FISU, and, you know, chasing World Cup titles. Impressive if you could do all three at the same time.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, Ramon, let's also talk about the Pyeongchang 2018 Olympic Winter Games. You won a silver medal in the slalom, second to Sweden's Andre Mir, I believe, and also winning a gold medal in the team event with your Swiss teammates in Pyeongchang. I mean, did everything go almost as good as possible for you there in South Korea in 2018?
Yeah, of course. I just won paraslalom before, and maybe 2 weeks before, and otherwise I was never on the World Cup podium, I think. And then I won the silver medal in Pyeongchang. But maybe also the university winter games in Granada helped me also in Pyeongchang, because the, you know, the organization was pretty similar. We live down in the city in Granada. You have these big hotels. You live with the other athletes there. From there, you have these shuttle buses going up to the ski resort. The organization is pretty similar. And yeah, in Pyeongchang, it was amazing for me to come back with two Olympic medals. I never imagined before I went to Pyeongchang that I will return with two silver medals.
And then you didn't get your first World Cup victory until 2019 afterwards. So the Olympic medal before the first World Cup victory.
Yeah, before the first World Cup victory in slalom, yeah. In parallel slalom, I did it before. Yeah, it's exactly. It was impressive also for me to winning the first World Cup podium in the Olympic Games. I think it's a lot in these big events. The favorites sometimes struggle, and then the undercovers were coming up. But it helped me a lot for my career, because after this, my career went straight up.
There you go. Good to hear. Glad to see that the Winter Universiade played such an integral role in your success in the years to come. Let's talk about Lucerne, the 2021 Winter Universiade, returning to Switzerland, coming back to your home country. It was supposed to be in January, obviously because of coronavirus and restrictions. It was moved to December of 2021. In Lucerne, and six cantons of Switzerland sharing the festivities and the events. I know you're a busy guy, and you know December is an important time to prepare and get ready on the World Cup. But what does it mean that Universiade is, you know, coming to Switzerland? And if your schedule permits, do you hope to get there and, you know, see some events?
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't participate because I'm too old then. But yes, I'm ambassador of this event, because I think it's a really good event, and I support the organization committee for everything. And I hope there will be also nice games, sport games. And yeah, maybe I will join a game and go seeing some competitions. I was also in Kazakhstan after Granada. I participated also in Kazakhstan. There were also nice games. So I'm surprised how they will do in Switzerland.
I think it will be very well organized. That's just my prediction.
I hope so. Yeah, I think too.
Hey, Ramon, the slogan is welcome home, hashtag welcome home for Lucerne Winter Universiade 2021. I mean, that's obviously appropriate for a Swiss alpine skier like you. That should make you even more excited, I would assume.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited, and I think it's a cool logo. And the ski sport in Switzerland, it's so a main topic, so a big thing in Switzerland. It's like in Austria or in Switzerland, they celebrate it really hard. All this winter sport, we live from winter sport, and for that, I think it's really nice to have this special event in Switzerland. Come back to the roots.
Well said, Ramon. Two more questions. I know you probably need to get some sleep for training in the morning on the hill. Speaking of, you know, being a Swiss alpine skier and the tradition and the fans, two amazing venues every year, obviously Wengen with the Lauberhorn and the Wengen Slalom. And of course, the weekend before in Adelboden in Switzerland. And you know, I've been there, and it's just a fantastic atmosphere with the Swiss flags and cowbells, obviously. But what does it mean for a Swiss skier to ski in iconic venues like Wengen and Adelboden?
Yeah, I think it's the biggest thing you can ski and you ski in Adelboden, and you have this crowd. When you come to the last pitch down in the steep part, you can hear it. All the crowd, and when you do a good time in the finish area, they cheers to you. And these two events are the highlights of the year for Swiss skiers. Yeah. It's pretty
nice.
And
then you celebrate eating some cheese, of course, right?
Yeah, maybe after the race, but not before the race. Yeah.
Ramon, last question. For a guy that's had so much experience like yourself, again, the two Winter Olympics, the 2015 Universiade in Granada, what advice would you give? What message would you tell young student athletes that may be juggling, you know, studies and an athletic career and have high aspirations? What would be your message to them?
I think my message is to continue also in sport, because in sport you can learn also a lot for the life. It's a good life education too, and you learn to be efficient with study and sport, and it's good for your body. So I motivate everyone who say sport and study, and I think with this possibilities. We have, for example, university, Swiss University, Fern Universiade. You can do both, because in the past it was a little bit different. It was difficult to do study and sport, and now it's possible. And motivate everyone to do that.
Ramon, danke schön. Appreciate your time today, taking a break from your training to talk to us here at FISU. And obviously wish you the best ahead with this upcoming World Cup season amid the uncertainty that all athletes, that everyone is facing right now.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. No problem.
All right. Hope to see you on the tour this season, or if not on tour, then definitely at Lucerne Winter Universiade 2021.
Exactly. See you in Lucerne.
And thanks to you for joining us on this edition of the University Legends interview series. I'm Ryan Pennelly. Stay tuned for future profiles of amazing athletes that began their careers at the Universiade. Have a great day, everybody.